The answer is all except for the third are true. The third is not true because encryption is generally faster than hashing. These three are really big problems with this scheme. Let's talk about the fourth one first. We need this key to decrypt. The program that's running on the server that needs to check passwords will need this key all the time. So chances are, if the password file is compromised, the key is also compromised because it's available in memory, it's stored in this program, or it's readily accessible because we need it every time we check a password. The solution to this is that we don't actually need to invert the password to check it's correct. All we need to do is recompute from the entered password some function and check that with what's stored. So there's no reason to have a key here. The first reason is also true, that because we're encrypting the password, the output that's the stored password will reveal the length. The reason that's a bad idea, well, it reveals information about the password. It also helps an attacker out, tells them which passwords are short, and that helps the attacker know which ones to try and break. The easy way to fix this is to use a hash function as well. If we use a hash function, the size of the output doesn't depend on the size of the input. So no matter how long the password is, we'll have the same number of output bits based on our hash function. The second one's a little more subtle. If we just use the hash function in a straightforward way, we won't save this problem. And this problem is pretty important. If you look at typical passwords, many are the same. And the most popular password, at least according to an analysis of leaked passwords, is 123456. If that's your password, you should probably change it. Out of the 32 million passwords that were leaked, so an analysis of the 32 million passwords that were leaked by rockyou.com, and they did not store passwords in an encrypted format, so all the actual passwords were easily revealed. The most popular password was 123456. Over 290,000 people use that for their password. That's almost 0.1%. So if this is your password, you should probably change it. Once you start looking at a set of a few thousand popular passwords, you're covering a large percentage of users. So this first approach fails on many accounts.